My name is Joseph Dinesh. Today I speak to you as a person who was addicted to pornography for 7 years of my adult life. Also as a person who thought that I have to live with this addiction for the rest of my life. Also as a person who has faced the worst of its consequences and have been deeply impacted. Well, my story goes like this. After my undergraduation, I returned home to start my professional career and pursue my dreams. But at the same time, a failed relationship and mounting family problems dwindled my enthusiasm on all fronts. Added to that, working in a 16-hour shift made my life a living nightmare. As a result, things were slowly turning from bad to worse. Fed up with myself, I could neither handle the heartbreak nor the lack of peace at home. Having hit the lowest point in my life, the stress and the anguish cornered me into a deep depression. To be really honest with you, I even thought of taking antidepressants and sleeping pills to ease my sorrow, my disappointment, and my agony. As the lions look for the weakest member of the herd to hunt, so was the devil at striking distance to devour me. Desperately looking for something that would liberate me from this ordeal, I unknowingly and unintentionally fell flat to the trap that was laid by the evil one. The fantasy world of pornography ensnared me. Despite the initial feeling of disgust, within a few days, I discovered that porn was pleasurable and it gave me a high like nothing else could. From then on, exploring the horizons of pornography became my ultimate expedition. Porn became the elixir that quenched the unbearable realities of my life. Porn became the ultimate recourse and a trusted companion. Every time I felt low or had a bad day, the drug of my choice was pornography. Subsequently, I habituated myself to carry this drug everywhere. As I embarked to do my management studies in one of the premier schools in India, the hostel single room, super fast internet connection, high configuration laptop enabled a conducive environment for porn to penetrate deep into my lifestyle. Instead of pursuing my passion for marketing, I pursued a lustful fantasy. Even my reputation as a spiritual person in college did not stop me from engaging in my sinful ways. Before long, my countenance revealed my private life, and soon I was discarded as an hypocrite. Couple of years later, the corporate world gave me a warm welcome. I was very much looking forward to have a fresh start, but you will never believe what happened. Instead of improving my skills to climb the corporate ladder, I used the company properties to bathe myself in the sewer of pornography. All I remember was watching porn in my workplace and doing the same after I returned home. It was sad but not surprising that I was kicked out of 3 companies in my 5 years of professional career. Before I could realize, without any warning, porn from being an innocent habit had progressed into a full-fledged addiction. Furthermore, the addiction was pushing me to the darker shades of the porn world to feel the same high. I was afraid of the things I was watching, but I could not help myself. I had become a slave indeed. The very medicine that I took to ease my pain had now become the poison that made my wounds bleed. I had lost my identity, had no sense of dignity, and lived a life of captivity. At this point in my life, I was jobless, abandoned by friends, and even my family gave up on me. Despite living in the pigsty, I could not come to my senses. Panic attacks frequented now and then. I did not know what was happening, but I knew I was one step closer to hell. Pornography had destroyed my life inside out. I thought it was the end. But somewhere deep within my heart, I knew that Providence would strike again, that there will be light shining at the end of the tunnel. I've heard people say that God always comes in search of that one lost sheep, but I never thought that it would be me. When the supernatural takes over your life, you know it. Yes, I knew it. Something was happening. Something was brewing, and the angels were on the move. The first act of Providence whispered a change in place that led me to leave my hometown and go work as a volunteer somewhere. After searching for a few days, I came across this HIV care home run by the St. Camillus Fathers for the HIV infected children. In that HIV care home, the love that the children showered on me revived my humanity. I completely gave myself to them teaching them music, spoken English, and Catholic spirituality. Over the course of my stay there, I suddenly woke up to this fact that these children knew that they were born with this dreadful disease for no mistake of their own. But yet, their lives were filled with gratitude and purpose. I took the time to introspect and see what was going wrong in my life. In the tranquility of my heart, the whispers of God's voice was tuning in. After a short stint there, I came back home, hoping that things would change for the better. Even though the grip of addiction had weakened, I was far from realizing that it was porn that was tearing apart my life into pieces, because of which healing was nowhere in sight. Soon after my return, the second act of providence showed itself. One day, I got a call from my very good friend, Jose Anthony, asking me to come and stay with his family and help him in his business venture. After praying over it, I decided to go. But I was very hesitant to stay in their home, considering that it would be uncomfortable for them and delicate for me. But God had ordained that I stay with this beautiful family for a purpose. Soon, I became acquainted with their daily schedule. Jose, along with his wonderful wife Sharu and their five amazing children, taught me how to live the sacramental life of the church. We went for daily mass, spent an hour before the Blessed Sacrament, did regular confessions, came together for family prayer, and ended our day with thanksgiving. Receiving the body and blood of Jesus every day was an healing ointment for my deep wounds. Moments before the Blessed Sacrament calmed my heart to identify my life's purpose. Sacrament of Reconciliation helped me realize God's limitless love and mercy, which urged me to get over my past life. The initial 3 months, I endured all the manifestations of a clinical addiction. Severe withdrawal symptoms, many sleepless nights, and constant torture of lustful thoughts were the order of the day. Surprisingly, in spite of all that, I did not give in. It made me wonder how all of a sudden I was not succumbing to the usual patterns and familiar trigger points. As time passed by, I realized that it was the sacramental grace that gave me the strength to say no to the persuading temptations, the nurturing family environment that kept me away from all occasions of sin, the sense of God's purpose that kept me on the go. A miracle was happening right before my eyes. What I thought was impossible was becoming possible. The chains forged in the evil fire of pornography were shattered into pieces. I regained my identity. I realized who I was and why I was created. And finally, the words of the famous song Amazing Grace dawned on my life. I was once lost, but now I am found. I was blind, but now I see. Yes, I was no more a slave. I was free. I was free indeed. After breathing a sigh of relief, I knew that I had to share this good news with you and the rest of the world. Hence this video. God bless you.